everybody, thank you so much for checking out my YouTube channel. I'm so excited. This is my first ever YouTube yoga class and I'm excited to share my practice with you. My name is Molly. You can read a little bit more about me in the description below, so make sure you check it out. This class is 36 minutes long. It's a perfect class for a Saturday or Sunday morning at a beginner yoga student level. So I hope you enjoy it. Please listen to your body, stay out of any painful range. And if you have any concerns about any health, you should probably not be doing this. Talk to your doctor first. So enjoy your class. Namaste.
Come to a kneeling position at the top of your mat. If you need a bolster or a pillow, you can wrap a pillow up and place it underneath your sit bones between your legs just to lift your hips up a little bit more. It just takes some pressure off of the knees. Close your eyes and start to tune into your breath. You can probably hear my dog snoring, so she can be my little pranayama leader. Place your right hand on your low belly, your left hand on your heart. As you inhale, push your belly out into your hand. As you exhale, let your hand move towards your spine, drawing your belly in. Inhale, push your belly out into your hand, filling your belly like a balloon. Exhale, draw your belly in. With your next inhale, fill your belly and then push your ribs out to the side, expanding out laterally. As you exhale, draw your ribs together and let your belly follow. Inhale, belly expands, side ribs expand. Exhale, ribs knit together, belly draws in. Inhale, belly expands, side ribs expand. Exhale, ribs draw in, belly draws in. And then completing the three-part breath, inhale, belly expands, side ribs expand, and then gently lift your chest. As you exhale, drop your chest down, ribs knit together, and belly descends. Filling our lungs up from the very bottom, inhale, belly, ribs, chest. Exhale, chest, ribs. Belly. Take one more breath. Release your hands down in front of you and just do some wrist circles going in one direction and then the other. And then notice as you're doing this, maybe close your eyes. Notice how your body is moving in those wrist circles. Are you making lots of corners? Is it more of a octagon versus a circle? And then slow your wrist circles down and see if you can smooth out the edges. So in this way, we're training our muscles to move the joint in all the free ranges of motion. And we're getting into all the sticky parts. So do the same thing, going the other direction again. Very Perfect. And then lift your sit bones up. Remove your bolster or your pillow that you have underneath you. And come to the center of your mat in a tabletop position. Spread your knees apart underneath your hips and your hands underneath your shoulders. And then look at your hands for a moment. Press your fingertips into the ground until your fingertips turn white. Press the underside of each knuckle and the heel of your hand. Gently draw up on a penny size portion of your inner palm as though you're suctioning it off the mat. This hand position is called Hastabandha, and throughout our practice and throughout my yoga classes, this will help you take any pressure off of the wrist joint. Inhale, drop your belly down, lift your tailbone, gaze forward. Exhale, tuck your tailbone under, round your spine slowly, look towards your knees. Inhale, lift your tailbone, allow movement to flow through your spine, drop your belly down, gaze forward. Exhale, round your spine, look towards your knees. Moving with your breath. Last time, inhale, drop your belly towards the ground, gaze forward. Exhale, round your spine, draw your belly up and in as you round a little bit higher. And then inhale back to center, point your toes behind you and press yourself into a child's pose, hips to heel, forehead to the ground. Inhale into the back body, expand your ribs out behind you. As you exhale, push your hands into the ground, encouraging your sit bones towards your heels. Inhale, lift your palms up, coming to tent your fingers on the mat, sending your wrists high. Hold for a breath. Inhale, send your wrists higher and reach them to the front wall. Exhale, bring your hands back to the ground. Lift your hips back up, come into tabletop position. Tuck your toes under. Inhale, lengthen the crown of your head forward. Exhale, lift your hips high, come into downward facing dog. For this variation, bend your knees and lift your heels high. Our goal for this variation is to have a straight spine over having straight legs. Inhale, lift your hips up high. Exhale, push into the ground as though you're moving the floor forward and away from your body. Inhale, lift your hips a little bit higher. As you exhale, draw your belly in and move your pubic bone backwards until you feel your lumbar spine lengthening. That's your low back. Inhale, push the ground forward and away from your body. Exhale, continuously draw your belly in and move your pubic bone backwards. And you'll feel a stretch in the upper hamstrings when you do this, even if your knees are bent. Hold one more breath. And on your inhale, slowly walk your feet all the way up to your hands, one foot in front of the other, getting a hamstring stretch in every step. When you get to the top of your mat, spread your feet apart hip distance. Bring your hands to your shins and inhale, lengthen the crown of your head forward, tailbone back. Exhale, draw your belly in, engage your quadriceps, and fold forward, Uttanasana. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold forward, getting into your hamstrings. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, last time, fold forward. Press into your feet, inhale, rise all the way up. lifting your arms overhead. Exhale, bring your hands together to heart center and release your hands beside you. Close your eyes and bring your feet together for Samasthitihi. Gently wobble forward and backward and side to side, noticing how the weight is transferred over your feet. When you find center point, come to stillness. Press your feet into the ground. As you inhale, grow taller. As you exhale, soften your shoulders down your back and allow your weight to sink through your feet. Inhale, lift your arms overhead, stretching towards the ceiling. Exhale, fold over your hip creases. Bring your hands to the ground, face towards your shins. Inhale, hands to shins, halfway lift. Exhale, place your hands on the ground and step backward into a plank position. Remember that Hasta Bandha connection into the ground, hands to floor. Inhale, lengthen the crown of your head and your heels apart. Soften your shoulders and hold one more breath. Inhale, push the ground away from you one more time. Exhale, slowly lower onto your belly, keeping your elbows nice and tight into the body. Turn your toes backwards, forehead on the floor. Inhale, roll your shoulders onto your back body and allow your upper body to peel away from the ground, coming into low cobra. Exhale, slowly come back down to the floor. Inhale, roll your shoulders onto your body and allow your arms to pull you back. Exhale, lower. One more time, inhale, rise up. Reaching your upper arms back, reach the sides of your neck back. Exhale, lower all the way down. Tuck your toes under. Inhale, lift your knees, and then allow your body to follow, rising back up into plank and transferring your weight backwards, downward facing dog. Inhale, lift your tailbone high. Exhale, move your pubic bone backwards again, finding the alignment of your lumbar spine in downward facing dog. Take two more long breaths. Transfer the weight onto your left foot. Inhale, your right foot lifts up. Exhale, bring your knee to your forehead. Draw your body away from the ground. Look between your knees and plant your foot down. Drop your left knee behind you. Inhale, rise your arms up, look up. Exhale, sweep your hands down and back. Inhale, lift your arms, look up. Exhale, sweep down and back. Again, inhale, rise up. And exhale, sweep your arms down and back. And as you do this, sweep your hips backwards, lengthening the front leg. Inhale, shift your weight forwards, lift your arms, look up. Exhale, sweep your hands down, shift your weight backwards, straighten your front leg. Inhale, last time, lift your arms, look up. Exhale, sweep your hands down, shift your weight back, straighten your front leg. Pause here, three breaths. On the inhale, shift your weight forward, bring your hands beside your right foot, and step up, halfway lift. Exhale, engage your quadriceps, fold forward, face to shins.
Inhale, rise up, lift your arms, look up. Exhale, hands to heart center, Samasthitihi. Inhale, lift your arms, look up. Exhale, fold forward over your hip crease, hands to the floor, face to shins. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, step your right foot back, drop your right knee. Inhale, lift your arms, look up. Exhale, sweep your hands down and back. Inhale, lift your arms, look up. Exhale, sweep down and back. Again, inhale, lift and look up. Exhale, sweep your hands down to the floor and shift your weight backwards for our hamstring stretch on the left. Inhale, moving with the breath, lift your hands, look up. Exhale, hands to the floor, shift your weight back, straighten your front leg. Inhale, shift your weight forward, last time, lift your arms, look up. Exhale, hands to the floor, shift your weight back, and pause, three breaths. As you rest here, slowly roll your shoulders onto your back body and lift your chest on the inhale. As you exhale, move into the space you've created. Inhaling to lengthen and lift. Exhaling to soften deeper into your pose. Let's hold one more breath. Inhale, shift your weight forward. Tuck your back toe under and plant your hands beside your left foot. Lift your back knee and step back into a plank position. Let's wake up our core a little bit. Press your fingertips into the ground. Push the ground away from your body. Soften your shoulders away from your ears. Inhale, lift your left leg up. Squeeze your glutes so that your hips don't shift an inch. Soften your foot back down to the ground. Squeeze your left glute, inhale, lift your right foot up. Hold strong. Soften your foot back down to the ground, and again, slowly, as slow as you can, lower all the way down to the floor. Point your toes back behind you, and this time bring your arms wide for cobra. Send your elbows to the ceiling, and inhale, peel your body away from the ground. Exhale, lower back down. Inhale, peel yourself away from the ground. Exhale, lower down. One more time, inhale. Pause at the top. As you exhale, soften your shoulders away from your ears. One more inhale, move your heart and sternum forward. Exhale, soften all the way down. Bring your hands back under your shoulders. Tuck your toes under. Inhale, lift your knees high and push up into a plank. Send your weight backwards, downward facing dog. Take three breaths here. Inhale, tailbone lifts. Exhale, move your pubic bone backwards. Inhale. Exhale, gently press into your hands, forward and away from your body. One more breath. Then inhale, step up to your hands, come up into a halfway lift. Exhale, fold forward, face to shins. Inhale, rise up all the way, hands to the sky. Exhale, hands to heart center, Samasthitihi. Come to the top of your mat, bring your weight onto your left foot. Hands on your hips, inhale, right foot lifts up. Exhale, step back 3.5, 4 feet so your back foot is perpendicular to your front foot. And then bend into both knees and shift your hips side to side a little bit. When you're ready,
Place your front knee directly over top of your heel and then encourage your knee to track towards your pinky toe so that your knee's not sinking in. Roll your body to face the right side. Inhale, arms lift up so they're parallel to the floor. Tuck your chin, look over your front fingertips. Inhale. Exhale, soften your shoulders. Inhale, pull your feet towards each other, activating your legs. Exhale, stretch through your fingertips. One more breath. Wrap your right hand behind you. Inhale, left hand lifts up, palm up, exalted warrior. Exhale, let's flow. Bring your forearm onto your front knee. Stretch your right hand overhead, extended side angle. Pause here for a couple breaths. Stretch your fingers high, bringing your bicep all the way to your ear, and press your right fingertips and right foot away from each other. Coming back into our flow. Inhale, lift your arms up through warrior two. Wrap your right hand behind you, left hand high, exalted warrior. Exhale, bring your front forearm on your knee. Reach your right hand overhead, back to extended side angle. Inhale, back to exalted warrior. Exhale, extended side angle. Pause here. Slowly wiggle your back foot in a couple movements, and then bring your left hand down to your shin, straightening your front leg. Inhale, roll your right shoulder on top of your left, and stretch your arm towards the wall in front of you. Roll your right shoulder open a little bit more. Exhale, stretch. Triangle variation. Engage your front quadriceps so that your front leg isn't hyperextended. And inhale, right hand lifts all the way up. Full variation of triangle. Bend your left knee. Bring your hand back onto your knee. Inhale, stretch overhead. Exhale, bring your right hand all the way to the floor. Lift your back heel up. And pause here in runner's lunge. Inhale, stretch the crown of your head forward, your right heel back. Drop your right knee down and bring your right hand nice and wide. And here, I like to turn my toes out to 10 o'clock. Inhale, gently encourage your body and your knee away from each other. Inhale, stretch your left hand overhead and turn your heart up to the ceiling. Option to take your hand to the nape of your neck and press your head and your hand together to open your heart a little bit higher. Slowly come back to center. Bring your hands to frame your left foot. Tuck your back toe under. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold forward, face to shins. Press into your feet, inhale, rise all the way up, lift your arms, look up. Exhale, hands down to heart center. Bring your hands back to your hips, and we'll do the other side. Settle your weight into your left foot, inhale. Exhale, step back 3.5, 4 feet, depending on how tall you are. And again, sink into your knees and shift your hips forward and backward a little bit. Getting all the creaks and the cracks out. Bend your front knee over top of your heel and again track it towards your pinky toe a little bit. Open your body to the left. Inhale, arms lift up so they're parallel to the ground. An option to sink a little bit deeper into your warrior two. Soften your shoulders away from your neck. Tuck your chin slightly. And look over your front fingers. Inhale, pull your legs together, activating your lower body. Exhale, stretch through your fingertips. turn your right hand up. Wrap your left hand behind you. Inhale, exalted warrior. Exhale, bring your forearm onto your right knee. Stretch your left hand overhead, extended side angle. Pause here for a breath. Make the adjustments that you need to for your body. Bringing your bicep closer to your ear, keeping your palm down. And stretching your left foot and your left hand away from each other. Coming back into our flow. Inhale through warrior two. Wrap your left hand behind you, lift your right hand high. Exhale, extended side angle. Inhale, exalted warrior. Exhale, extended side angle. Inhale. Exhale. Pause here for a moment, and then bring your right hand down to your shin and squeeze your right quadricep to push your hips backwards and straighten your front leg. Roll your shoulders one on top of the other and pull your legs together for our Trikonasana, our triangle variation. Stretch your left hand towards the wall in front of you, bringing your bicep closer to your ear. So eventually there's one line from your fingertips all the way to your left hip. Hold here, softening. Inhale, lift your left hand high, keeping your chin tucked as you gaze up past the left fingertips. Bend your right knee, bring your forearm back onto your knee, lengthen in to extended side angle. Slowly lower your left hand down to the floor and come into runner's lunge, lifting your left heel. Inhale, lengthen the crown of your head and your heel away from each other. Exhale, drop your left knee down and step your left hand off nice and wide. And again, option to turn your right foot out so that it's facing 2 o'clock. Slowly encourage your knee and your heart away from each other. And then sweep your right hand overhead. And again, option to bend your elbow and take your head in your hands and press your hand and your head together to open your heart up to the ceiling. Slowly release. Walk your hands to frame your right foot. Lift your back knee up and step up halfway lift. Exhale, fold forward, bring your face to your knees. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, face to knees. One more time, inhale. Exhale, face to knees. And then step back and lower to your knees. We're gonna transition onto our backs. Team your arms out straight. Stretch your hands out. I'm gonna shimmy back to my mat here. Stretch your arms out, stretch your legs out, and draw your right knee into your chest. Interlace your fingers around your knee. Inhale, draw your knee backwards. Soften your shoulders away from your ears. You might notice in this pose that the left hip wants to lift off the ground. Encourage that left hip to stay flush to the floor. Inhale, draw your knee back again. Exhale, soften your left shoulder to the floor. Take 2 more breaths. Then inhale,
Bring your hands onto the back of your hamstring, just as a support, and lift your heel high. Now it may be that your foot's down here, and that's okay. Wherever you are is fine, as long as you're feeling an engagement through the front quadricep and a stretch up the back of the hamstrings. Inhale, stretch your heel up a little bit higher. And exhale, release your hands and slowly bring your heel to the floor. When your heel touches down, draw your left knee into your chest, interlacing your hands, and using the strength of your biceps to draw your knee towards your left shoulder. Again, your right shoulder and your right hip want to be on the floor. Inhale, draw your left knee in a little bit closer to your shoulder. Exhale, soften your shoulders until you feel a lengthening in the sides of your neck. Take one more deep inhale. Deep exhale. And then again, transfer the hands behind the hamstrings and lift your left heel high. And again, back off if you need to. Engaging your front quadricep, stretching your back hamstrings. Hold here. Send your heel up a little bit higher. And slowly release your hands and soften your heel back down to the floor. When your heel touches down, bend your knees. Lift your hips up and place them on the left side of your mat, bringing your feet together. Tee your arms out beside you and soften your knees down to the right. And here, it might be helpful if you take your bolster or your pillow that you used earlier and allow your knees to rest on that so that you didn't have so much torque going through your spine. If both shoulders are resting firmly on the ground, feel free to look over your left shoulder, coming into a full spinal twist. Close your eyes. Allow the weight of your body to sink into the ground. And come back into the three-part breath that we practiced at the beginning of class. Inhale into the belly, the side ribs, and the chest. Exhale, chest drops down, ribs knit together, belly descends. Inhale, belly, ribs, chest. Exhale, chest, ribs, belly. Draw your belly in and bring your knees back to center. Realign your hips and your heels on the mat and reach your hands down towards your heels. Now your heels, if you move side to side, you should be able to just touch your heels, so your fingers are about an inch and a half, 2 inches away from your feet. Separate your knees and your hips, your knees and your feet, hip distance apart. And inhale, lift your hips up nice and high. Exhale, vertebrae by vertebrae, roll back down onto the ground so that you can feel each and every segment touching down. When you're all the way down, inhale, lift your hips again. Exhale, again, slowly lowering down. Let's do that one more time. Inhale, lift your hips up. Exhale, vertebrae by vertebrae, slowly lower down. And then T your arms out again. And right away, you might want to take your bolster and put it on the other side. Lift your hips over to the right. So the more you lift, the more space you create for your twist. And then bring your feet together and drop your knees down to the left. And here you can adjust your pillow or your bolster to support your legs effectively. Invite a heaviness into your body, allowing your shoulders to soften, allowing your legs to relax. And again, if your shoulder, your right shoulder, is firmly planted against the ground, feel free to look over your right shoulder towards your fingertips. And here you can close your eyes. Draw your belly in, bring your head back to center if it's over your shoulder, and draw your knees back to center. Shift your hips and your heels evenly on the mat, and then bring your hands beside you, palms up, and stretch your heels out. Inhale. As you exhale, sigh. Again, inhale. Exhale and sigh. And release control of your breath. Allow your body to sink into the ground and soften into your Shavasana.